It's day 39 of 100 Days of Code, and we're going to be building the children's game Hangman. Now, you'll be using a lot of your skills today, not least lists, string slicing, and string manipulation. There's a lot going into this, so don't be afraid to check solutions if you are struggling, because this is the first project we've done which combines such a lot of different things into one. You're going to create a list that contains at least 10 different words. You can make these words up or get them from an online dictionary resource of some kind, but at least 10 different words should be in that list. You then need to pick from that list randomly. Now, I want to take a little pause to show you how you can do that. The random library, we've only ever used the function randint. That picks a random number. Well, luckily for us, we can use random.choice. In the brackets of random.choice, we need to give it a list. Luckily, our list of words is one such thing. This will return to us one of the words at random. You can see here that it's picking one of the words from the list randomly each time. Now, clearly you don't want to print it out, but you need that random.choices function to work in order to randomly pick one of your words. Once you've picked one of your words, what you need to do then is prompt the user to type in a letter. You need to see if that letter exists in the string. If it does, you want to show them a string which is all blank apart from the letters they've picked. You also need to keep a running list of the letters they've used and count how many times they've picked a letter that isn't in the word. If they get past 6, that is the end of the game. However, they win by revealing all the letters and announce that to them. There's a bunch of stuff going on here that you really need to think about quite carefully and practically to get this working. Special consideration goes for anyone that's able to show ASCII art of the Hangman graphics popping up on the screen as they go. You can Google for Hangman ASCII art if you'd like, and get that looking a bit prettier than what we've got at the moment. If you're struggling with this a little bit, don't forget you can go to ask.replit.com and click on the 100 Days of Code link to find places where you can discuss all the projects, or you could join us for our live session every other Wednesday of Replit 101 and the Coding Helpline, where we take your coding questions and talk to you about how you could fix your problems or better structure your code. Whatever you've got done, share it with us in the community by publishing it, and use the hashtag Replit 100 Days of Code to share your first properly engaging game with your followers and us. We'd love to see what you've done. Tomorrow, we're going to be looking at a slightly different form of list called a dictionary, which has one extra feature, which is very, very handy.